Yo, what is going on, you guys? So I just wanted to do a video on some of the newer knives that I've gotten lately. And changed up the background. This isn't going to be a permanent thing just because it's so fucking wild. But it is super cool. And this picture has a little bit of meaning behind it. I mean, obviously, let me move this fucking knife real quick. Pretty crazy shit, right? It's got the, the fucking shrine up here under the nice tree with the waterfall flowing down. And it's got the ship, and it's kind of sailing off into the sunset. And on the other side, it's got the rocks and the nice little inlet with the fucking Japanese bridges and shit. And what I fucking love about this picture is, one, my brother drew it, and he gave it to me for my birthday, like, years and years ago, before we were, you know, had money and bought each other actual fucking gifts. He had a nice frame and gave this up to me. And so I've held on to it for years and years, man, it's always one of my favorite picks. And, you know, the pick tells it. My brother's always been a little bit of a free spirit, you know, not saying he's a complete fuck-up, but, you know, he's had his share of drugs and fun in his day, so this was probably one of those influence nights that he drew this. But I gotta say, man, I love it. And the one thing I do love about it is the ship right here. I mean, clearly, it's sailing off into this crazy, you know, insane psychedelic sunset. But what I really like about it is it's kind of like, is the ship sailing off to another adventure, or, you know, off fucking for another journey, or is it just kind of sailing off into that beautiful sunset to end his days? I don't know. Pretty fucking cool, man. So anyway, thought I'd use this as my background. It looked pretty fucking cool. And that's the background of the background. Sipping on this beer, if you guys like a Heffenweizen Mission Street beer, this is absolutely delicious stuff. Got that at Trader Joe's. I don't know, it was like $2.99 or something for a pint of beer. Pretty good. So, first thing I wanted to show you real quick was one of the newer knives I got. And this is a Strider, but it is one of the black market Striders. And I came up on this thing from a buddy of mine. Wanted to check it out, hear what the hype's about. And I'll tell you what, it's actually made really solid. It's got a insane lockup, like super, super solid lockup. The blade is just sharp titties, you know, razor sharp. And, you know, I'm not really into the whole China clones and all that shit. You know, just leave me out of it. I could really care less. I mean, the knives are knives. I'm a knife fan. And I'll tell you what, this is actual quality knife. The only thing that bugs me is the fact that it has the Strider logos on there. If those were rubbed off, I mean, you know what? It's still a fucking straight ripoff, but I wouldn't have as much of a problem with it. So, just wanted to show you. I might do a teardown of this and maybe put it to the test with a couple hard use type of deals and see how it holds up. One thing I did do was, you can see here on the lock bar side, I took my Dremel and just fucking milled that out, because it was super uncomfortable grabbing it with your thumb to unlock, and now it's just, you know, perfect. So, and it did take me a while to get it a little bit smooth. When I first got it from the dude, it was like super gritty, and I got it pretty smooth now. So that's one of the blades I got there. And then the other one that I recently picked up and have been carrying around, it's funny because some people say it's the Strider fake clone too, and it's the HK Conspiracy. Some people say it's kind of got that Strider ZT301 look. It's kind of like a, you know, bastard stepson of the ZT301 and a Strider. But the reason, part being why I'm getting these knives, is I am on summer break, so I'm not really getting an income. I don't have the flow to be buying some super nice knives, although I would love to. And the other reason, I do have a custom knife being made at the moment, and it's actually getting finished up, so I'm gonna have to pay for that pretty soon. And I might have to sell a few knives to just cover that. It's not super expensive, but, you know, I'm always buying knives, so need to budget somehow. Just a quick sharpness test. Funny, I found this fucking fantasy football draft 2009 version, and I just pulled out a page. It's like, you can check, you know, what the rankings were fucking back in the day. Pretty funny. But, dude, this thing comes fucking just insanely razor sharp. I mean, this is just, you know, push cuts and push wave cuts and stuff. Pretty fucking sharp, as you can see. So, and then the HK as well. And the HK is this, the 13 MOV steel, the China steel. And, you know, I don't mind it. I've heard good things. Smoke-Eater did that sharpness retention test, and it, you know, they seem to hold up pretty good, and you could sharpen them up real quick, so I don't have a problem with it. And this thing just came. Sorry, that was a bad cut. This thing came insanely sharp out of the box as well. I did not strop this thing or nothing, so. And I've actually been using this for about a week or so, and this thing, it's got that bead blast finish. I actually threw it in my pocket with all my fucking keys and chains and shit, and god dang, it took a beating, man. That's why I hate that bead blast or media blast finish. I wish they would have stonewashed it. So, these are the two blades recently that I've been picked up. I just wanted to share them with you guys. Got a bunch of G10 here. Probably going to be making some scales for... Definitely going to make some scales for this HK. Not sure about the Strider. Fucking Strider clone. I got some G10 just stamped over here. I'm going to... It's jade with a OD green liner. Probably going to make a scale out of that. So check for that in the coming days. And I will leave you staring at the ship sailing off into that sunset. You be the decider of what it's going out to do. Thanks for watching, you guys. Appreciate it, as always. And I will see you next time.